Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Technical Experience. Today I shall be discussing what is LBB or what is local breaker backup used in a substation. Local breaker backup is a technical condition which comes into force when a circuit breaker comes in a contingent condition. During a fault, when a particular circuit breaker fails to operate, then the other associated circuit breakers, those who come in action to rescue the situation, that kind of arrangement is called LBB or local breaker backup. First, we shall try to understand how this LBB operates in different busbar arrangements. Then we shall discuss how this LBB relay works through panel drawings. First, we shall see how LBB operates in a single busbar scheme. Regarding busbar scheme, I have already uploaded videos. The link will be given in the description box. In this busbar scheme, if we consider there is a fault in one of the feeder, then the direction of the fault current will be in this way. So as to clear the fault, the associated circuit breaker of the feeder, that is this circuit breaker, is supposed to trip. That will further protect the fault from propagating through the bus and also protect all other feeders connected to the bus from that fault. But in case of failure of the circuit breaker for operation during fault, a signal will be generated from that particular feeder to operate all other feeders connected to the busbar. Now we will see how LBB operates or functions in main and transfer busbar scheme. We know in main and transfer busbar scheme, all the feeders are connected to the main busbar and the transfer busbar is kept isolated. That is, the bus coupler connected in between main and transfer busbar is kept open always in normal condition. Hence, in this scheme also, due to the failure of a particular circuit breaker, the all other circuit breakers connected to the main bus will be operated because of the generation of LBB. Hence, the LBB scheme for the single busbar scheme as well as the main and transfer busbar scheme will be the same. Now, we shall see how this LBB operates in a double busbar scheme. Friends, we know in double main busbar scheme, half of the feeders in a substation are connected to one of the bus and the remaining half are connected to the other bus. And the bus coupler is always kept in service to connect bus 1 and 2. In such situation, when a fault occurs in feeder number 1, the circuit breaker of feeder number 1 is supposed to operate to clear the fault. But if the circuit breaker of feeder number 1 fails to operate, an LBB signal will be generated from feeder number 1 which will be directed towards the circuit breaker which are connected directly to bus bar 2. So, the circuit breaker of feeder number 2 which is directly connected to bus number 2 will trip, and along with that, the circuit breaker for bus coupler is also directly connected to main bus 2. So, that circuit breaker will also trip because of the generation of LBB from feeder number 1 to clear the fault. Hence, in this scheme, it can be observed that because of operation of LBB, all the feeders connected to the substation will not trip. Rather, the feeders which are connected to the other bus will be safe. Now, let us see how this LBB operates in case of one and half breaker scheme. On working of one half breaker scheme, I have a separate video. The link of that video will be shared in the description box. Now suppose there is a fault in one of the feeder. So the fault current which will flow through feeder will be from tie side and main CV side. So as to clear the fault, the circuit breaker, that is tie CV and the main CV, will trip normally. But if we consider, if because of some problem the main CV do not operate, in that situation, because of the operation of the tie CV, the fault current which was earlier flowing from tie CV side will stop flowing. But the current which was flowing from main CV side will continue to flow. Hence, to stop the flow of the fault current through this main CV, the main CV of other feeder will trip. Now, we shall consider the second case, that is non-operation of tie CV. During this condition, because of the operation of main CV, the fault current which was flowing from main CV side, that will stop flowing. But the current from the tie CV side will continue to flow. So as to get rid of that situation, an LVP signal will be generated from the feeder to trip the main CV of the other side feeder. This is how the LVP signals are mapped in 1.5 breaker scheme. Friends, this was all about LVP signal mapping in different bus bar scheme. Now we will see how these LVP signals are generated from this LVP relays. This is a schematic diagram of an LVP relay which is connected in 1.5 breaker scheme. If we look at the diagram from the top left, we will be able to see the 50 Z component that is an LVP relay. It is shown for the current connection of the LVP unit. If we look at the current connection of the LVP unit, we will be able to see the currents are in series with the overcurrent protection relays. Hence, for operation of the LVP relay, it is must that the current through the LVP relay and also the overcurrent relays are to be there, which is considered the first criteria for operation of LVP. If we look at the top right side of the drawing, we will be able to see the 50Z unit, that is the LVP relay, how it is connected for its DC connection. The DC connection to this relay is given through the main protection relay or the backup protection relay or the lookout relay or bus bar protection relay. This is considered the second criteria for operation of LVP. So if we look at the operation of LVP, we'll be able to find the DC supply to the LVP relay will be through only when the main protection relay or the backup protection relay, lockout protection relay or the bus bar protection relay operates. But in normal condition, on operation of any such protection relays, the circuit breaker of the particular feeder will trip. As a result, the current flowing through the feeder will stop flowing. Hence, in normal condition, when there will be a fault in the feeder, the DC will be through to the LVP relay. But at the same time, the current through the LVP relay will not be available as the circuit breaker will trip immediately. Hence, the LVP relay will operate only when the DC supply to the LVP relay will be through as well as the current through the LVP relay will be through. Such situation is only possible when the circuit breaker do not operate because of the operation of any of this protection relays. Further, if we look at the drawing, we'll be able to find on actuation of the LVP relay, the auxiliary contacts, those that open, will get closed, and through those closed contacts, the DC is further extended up to the time delay unit of the LVP relay. The output of the time delay unit of the LVP relay is further given to the bus bar protection. As this is a drawing for 1.5 breaker scheme substation, here in this case, the operation of LVP will lead to operation of all the remaining circuit breakers, that is, operation of bus bar protection is required. However, in different kind of bus bar arrangements, this output will be given to the other circuit breakers. Now, the question is why this time unit in the LVP relay is used. This delay unit in the LVP relay is provided to delay the operation of the LVP. That means when both the criteria for operation of LVP will be fulfilled, that is when there will be current flowing through the LVP relay as well as any of the protection relay actuates, in that case LVP will get initiated. But the operation of LVP will take place only after the time delay unit is actuated. Time delay can be set manually. The range is from 0.1 second to 1 second. In general practice, we set a time delay of 200 milliseconds for the LVP relays. Hence, operation of LVP relays will take place only when both the criteria for operation of LVP are satisfied and both the condition prolongs for more than 200 milliseconds. Then only LVP of a particular feeder will actuate. Friends, if you like the explanation, please share the video with your friends.